Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Summer Lynn, if you are new here. Today I'm doing a video that should have been up like a freaking 2 weeks ago, but I am just getting around to it. And you guys, I honestly think this was like my first video that I ever filmed. I'm really excited for this year because I'm going to really put an effort into just growing my channel and really just like giving you guys content every single week. So I'm super excited. I haven't decided what day a week I will upload. If you guys have a preference for when you're on YouTube the most or when you'd like to see my videos the most, let me know in the comments below. But yeah, for now my goal is to upload at least once a week, and yeah, I think that'll just be a good goal for now, and we'll just see how that goes. But anyway, today's video is my 2020 beauty favorites, which I'm so excited to film because I love watching these videos. You guys, I literally make a list. Like, I have a huge notebook, which I'm obsessed with notebooks, but I have a huge notebook and I will write down everybody's favorites, and then throughout the year I'll like go and get different ones and try them out, and it's just like my favorite thing ever. I love hearing what you guys are loving too, so make sure you comment below your favorites for 2020 and let's just get started. Okay, so my first favorite is actually a curling iron, and it is the, I'm not even really sure how to pronounce this, you guys. I don't know if it's Babyliss or Babyliss, but it is just this iron and I'm obsessed with it. It's like an actual curling iron with a clamp and everything. It's this light blue color and it heats up so fast. If you guys didn't know, I actually do weddings and proms, formals, pictures, stuff like that on the weekends as a little side gig. I did go to cosmetology school, so I have my license. This was just like my most used iron this year and I love it. I think it's probably like an inch and a half. Everything that I talk about will be linked down below, so you can go check this one out, but I love it. It's so nice. You can use it to wrap your hair around. You can actually use the clamp if you want. You can make real pretty curls, or you can just do a loose wave, but I think it's just like so versatile and I love it. And honestly, I didn't really even pack any other things in my kit this year for weddings and stuff. I just like thought this was perfect for any look. So yeah, that is my first favorite and I am obsessed with it. Let's jump into makeup. This is not going to be in any particular, this is not in any particular order, but the first favorite that I have is this Cheek Leader Bronze Squad palette from Benefit, and it is freaking beautiful. First off, we have a mirror, which, sorry to blind you guys, but I love palettes that come with mirrors because it's just like so handy. And the actual palette itself comes with Hoola bronzer. These are all full sizes. Hoola bronzer, a Hoola caramel bronzer, which right now I'm pale as can be. I'm also over here. I don't have any tan on. But when I do have a spray tan, this is like the perfect Hoola. It's so warm and beautiful. But right now I use it in my crease as just like an eyeshadow. Love it. Comes with two blushes, Gold Rush and Coralista. And then this highlighter is literally amazing. It's so beautiful. It's so creamy. I love that I have everything in there for like my face that I need. And okay, so that is my first favorite. I love it. I haven't even really tried a ton of Benefit products, but the ones that I've tried, I've been obsessed with. Okay, so another favorite that I had was just blush. Like, 2020 was the year of blush for me. I actually have started to like blush contour, which is like a new thing. It's kind of overexposed in here, so you can't see how bright it is, which is why I wear darker makeup when I film. But basically, blush is just giving me life. I used to never wear blush because, you guys, I have really big cheekbones. Like, they're like little golf balls, you know? So I used to be afraid of blush, and now I've really just taken my big cheekbones and like learned to love them and accentuate them. So like, give me the blush, give me the highlighter. I love it all. Obsessed with blush. And I love that another trend coming in 2021 is blush, blush, blush. And I'm so excited because now I won't look like a clown when I'm out, which I don't really care if I do anyway, but yeah, blush. Anyway, my favorite blushes, I actually have two, which is a little bit crazy because I used to never even wear blush. But my favorite so far is this palette, and it's a Profusion palette, which I got at Target. And you guys, are you serious? These are really, really good quality blushes, and they have like shimmers, even have like a little highlighty one right here. I have two of their cheek palettes and I could not be more impressed. They're cruelty free too, if that's up your alley. And yeah, when I'm doing makeup, like on myself or on clients, I take both of these palettes and you literally have everything that you need. You can get at the drugstore. Like, a lot of my favorites this year were drugstore products because I just didn't have money to go to Sephora to spend and drop like 30 bucks on a freaking blush, where you can get this. I think this was like $14. I don't know how many they have, but I want all of them because it's such good quality. Like, these blushes are like equivalent to Sephora Ulta high-end blushes. Okay, my absolute favorite, this, I think this might be my favorite of the year. Okay, let me tell you, it's the ColourPop Drop of a Hat Super Shock Cheek Cream Blush. And I've hit pan on it, as you can see. It's like a sheeny, beautiful blush. Like, but this is just, it's so soft, it's so creamy. It's just, it's beautiful. Like, it's stunning. It's beautiful in any season. It just makes you look so youthful and beautiful and just like flushed cheeks that are just still like kind of dewy. And it's just like my favorite product of the year. My favorite product. And I've gotten a couple more, but this is my favorite shade. It's got like a gold reflex in it, and you can wear it like no matter your skin tone, and it looks gorgeous. For like no makeup days, especially like for like no makeup makeup days, this has been just so fun to put on. Like, it's just so pretty. You can just put a little bit of mascara on, a little bit of this, a little bit of chapstick, and you just look so beautiful. Or you can do a full face and throw this on, and it just looks so pretty. And what I love doing with this is putting it all the way under my temples, so it acts like a highlighter, and I bring it all the way in, and then I put it over my nose a little bit to give you that like sun-kissed like little burn almost. That was like a super hot trend this year, and I'm still obsessed with it. So I know that Ulta sells ColourPop, and it's not like super expensive. Sorry, I keep playing with my hair. It's just like so hot in here, and it's just so much. You guys, seriously, what I want to do this year is chop my hair. Am I crazy? So what I'm thinking is like, it's gonna look kind of funny because my hair is like curled a little bit weird, but like I wanna chop it like kind of like this, I think. I feel like it looks so chic and like beautiful, and maybe I'm just watching too much Keaton Milburn and Bebe Hay, but like their short hair, it gives me life. But also I feel like my long hair is just so fun to play with and like do styles with. So I don't know, let me know in the comments if I should chop my hair, because I really want to, but I don't know if I'll actually go through with it, you know what I mean? More face products. The drugstore just killed it this year, as I've said 1,000 times in this video. But these foundations are both from the drugstore and my most used foundations. I don't get it, but it's just amazing. These are both Maybelline foundations. Congratulations, Maybelline, for freaking kicking butt on your foundations this year. So let's talk about them. This one is the Superstay Full Coverage. I'm pretty sure I've talked about this on my channel before, but it's full coverage. I'm wearing it actually right now, and obviously not this shade, a lighter shade, but it is so full coverage, but it doesn't feel like anything. It doesn't feel cakey or heavy, but I feel like it's hard at the drugstore to find full coverage foundations that actually look good, and this is amazing. Once again, I used this on all my brides this year. I used it on myself, I used it on my clients, and I'm just obsessed with it. I've recommended it to literally everybody. So along that line for foundation, this Dream Urban Cover sunscreen makeup was amazing, especially for warmer months. This is so lightweight. It's like kind of dewy. It's pretty sheer. You can still build it up if you need some coverage. It's not gonna give you full coverage like that. I'd say it's a light to medium, but this makes your skin look so beautiful. I think I've gone through like 3 or 4 of these. It's just like a beautiful everyday makeup. If you're not someone that wants a lot of makeup, it's just gonna give you just a pretty, pretty base. And it also has sunscreen in it, which is amazing. SPF 50, actually. So yeah, this summer I use this all the time. And I do still use it on like my days off, or like when I'm not doing a lot of makeup, just for like a no makeup look. And I just think it's so good. And you can find it at the drugstore, so I don't know what more you could ask for. Okay, these are drugstore products too. I feel like this is just a drugstore favorite year. Like, there are a couple high-end products, but not really any. So this is a newer favorite for me, and it's the CoverGirl Clean Fresh Pressed Powder. And it just looks like this. You can't really even see it because it's such a light shade, but it comes in this really pretty just pink packaging, which I'm obsessed with. I was obsessed with light pink this year. I'm always in love with pink, but like light pink, it was just like my favorite color ever. And now my favorite color has started to become like green, which is weird, but I'm growing up, I'm really maturing, and I guess like I'm growing into loving green and not just pink. Anyway, this is just a really good powder. It's so pretty. This is also a clean product, and I love that it has a mirror. I love how compact it is. It just gives good coverage. Honestly, I've been wearing this every single day, which if you guys want like an updated everyday makeup routine, let me know, because as you guys know, I've always struggled with my skin, and like look at how clear it's getting. So if you guys want a skincare routine too, let me know. But anyway, the only thing left on my skin really, besides like a few breakouts sometime, is like the hyperpigmentation that's left with it, which is basically like really light scars. And so I don't want to wear heavy foundation every day to work, and I've just been using this and it covers it. It's beautiful. I get it from Target, like just a good solid product, and you can set your foundation with it too. Then my favorite bronzer of the year was a NYX one, and this is in the shade medium, and you literally can barely see anything because I've like used all of it. There's also a mirror, which is great. This is just a really pretty like sunburnt bronzer. I don't think I used it today because I'm pretty pale, but usually this is my favorite one. I should try to get it in the light too and see if that color is just as pretty, but this medium one, it's like that pretty terracotta, like not too orange. It's more of a red tone bronzer. It looks kind of light on here, but it is pretty dark. So I was obsessed with this. It's matte, so you can contour with it too. And it's just like a really bomb bronzer, and I loved it. Okay, my next favorite is a mascara, which I'm like not that picky with mascara because I feel like I'm always wearing falsies if I even put mascara on. So I don't know, but when I do wear mascara and I like care what it looks like, this has been my favorite one. It's the Voluminous Lash Paradise, which I'm sure you guys have already heard of if you love makeup. Basically, it's just like the Better Than Sex one from Too Faced at Sephora for a fraction of the price. The wand is literally the exact same thing. I love it because it's a thicker mascara, but not clumpy. So like, you know, some mascaras you put on and they're so watered down that like you feel like there's nothing happening when you put it on. This one's thicker, which I prefer a thicker mascara because if I'm gonna put it on, I wanna be able to tell that it's on. But I also don't think it's super clumpy where it's gonna fall off your lashes or anything. So I really love this. Honestly, I love mascaras once they get a little bit older because they usually thicken up, but this one's thick from the beginning. She's thick and I love it. So check this one out. Lastly, for makeup are some lip products because I'm obsessed with lip products. I think lip liner was probably my favorite product to use this year. And I got a lot of questions, honestly, like as I was doing my makeup this year with like swipe ups or DMs of what I was wearing. So I wanna just give you guys like my favorite brands because I have a lot of colors in these, especially the lip liners. So my two favorite lip liner brands this year were the MAC ones. I think MAC lip liners are so bomb. They last a long time. They're just like beautiful. This shade is in Spice. And I know I used Strip Down and Coffee a lot this year too. You do have to sharpen these ones, but I feel like you can't go wrong with these. They're really nice because I like to overline my lips. So when I do my lips, I overline the Cupid's bow and under here. And I like that the MAC ones are thick enough that they'll actually look overlined instead of like showing my actual lip line and then my overlining, if that makes sense. So I was obsessed with MAC lip liners and MAC lipsticks. I love them. I don't think anyone talks about MAC anymore, but I'm still obsessed and I love their lip products. Okay, so these other lip liners are so random, but these are like my favorites. These are the Palladio lip liners. I've never even really heard of that brand. I got them at Sally's. They're so good, you guys. This color is in the shade Cranberry, and I love that the tops show you the color of them. They're probably only a few dollars at Sally's. I think I have like every single one of them because I love them. They're so creamy, they're pigmented, they just get the job done and can't go wrong with them. And my last two favorites are these two lip glosses. This is a high-end one and this is the Marc Jacobs lip gloss in Sugar Sugar. I basically put this on the middle of my lips with like any lip combo I'm wearing. I don't think I did today yet though. They smell like mint, they're just beautiful. And I'll literally just put it right here. See how it just like takes it up a notch? These lip glosses are so good if you want to splurge. They're minty, they're lightweight, they're creamy, they feel amazing, they're just beautiful. All around, just such a good lip product. And then if you're on a budget for a lip gloss, the NYX Butter Glosses are just so good. Like these could cost 25 bucks and I'd still buy them because I'm obsessed with them. They're so creamy. They're from the drugstore, so that's nice. They're actually really pigmented too. This color I've been wearing a lot lately is called Fortune Cookie, and it's a light nude. So if I'm doing a nude lip, I'll do like a strip down liner, fill it in a little bit, put like a nude lipstick on, and then just put this in the middle, and I'm loving it. Last product that I loved for beauty was this hair oil. It's so good. This is a 100 proof treatment oil from Drybar, which I did go to Drybar. It wasn't this year because COVID, it was the last year, and it was like such a fun experience. If you have a Drybar in your town, I'm so jealous. But anyway, their products smell so good. I can't explain what they smell like because I am just challenged with trying to describe scents, but it smells really good. It's just a good oil. Helps control frizz, helps add shine, smooths, replenishes your hair. Usually I put this on like before bed when I brush my hair and it like gets kind of frizzy or whatever, because I just have fine tangly hair. I'll put this on before I like braid my hair, or I'll put this on after the shower. I just try to remember to put it on because it's really just good for your hair to have a treatment oil, and this one is just one of my favorites and I highly recommend it. Okay guys, so that is all for my 2020 favorites for beauty. I'm actually so proud of myself that like 80% of the products were drugstore. The drugstore just really stepped their game up this year, so I was really happy with a lot of their products. Like I said before, please comment your favorite products, or if you have tried any of these, or if you're going to try any of these, I would love to know. I'll be filming a 2020 lifestyle favorites that include fashion, books, movies, podcasts, just random snacks, anything that I loved that wasn't like beauty related, that will be in that video. So if you want to see that one, make sure you stick around by subscribing below. So yeah, that is all for my favorites this year. And I hope you guys love this video. Please be sure to like and comment. I love interacting with you guys. Also, be sure to follow me on Instagram. I'll link it right here. I'm trying to post on there a lot more this year, and just more like stuff that I want to post, and like aesthetic and just like things that I want to post. So I'm excited for that this year. Be sure to follow me on there so you can see my favorites in action, how I wear things, how my makeup looks, things like that. I'm so excited for the content coming and to just really start grinding on my goals and on my channel and my pages and stuff. So be sure to stick around for that, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.